sitting way up here in this fine spring day.
Aw, nothing.
Kind of bored, I guess.
Oh, that's right. School's out for you, ain't it?
Yeah, Easter break.
Say, you youngins wanting to hear one of Uncle Yule's stories, then, would you?
Yeah.
Please, Uncle Yule.
Now, let's see. I told you about the time them city kids got stuck out in the country for Christmas, now, didn't I?
Yeah, we heard all about that story. Cousin Lucian and Cora May like to tell us that story, too.
They said you told those city kids the real Christmas story.
That's right, youngins. Your old Uncle Yuletide told them about the wise men, the shepherds, and the angels, and how God himself sent his son down to the little old town of Bethlehem. Then youngins heard the gospel for the very first time right here.
We love that story too, but can't you tell us a story we haven't heard?
Well, let's see. Did I ever tell you about the time that Luther, Cora, Mamie, and Granny went to the city to visit them newfound city cousins?
No, Uncle Yule, you never told us that story.
Well, it's quite a tale.
Tell us, Uncle Yule.
Alrighty, I reckon I can remember. Let's see. It was a fine spring day, kind of like today. We got this here letter in the mail.
What did the letter say?
Well, it was from Daniel and Chelsea and their ma and pa.
The city cousins?
Well, they ain't really our kin, you know, but we call them that anyhow. So they invited us to the city to spend Easter with them.
Where do they live, Uncle Yule?
Well, they live in New York City.
New York City?
That's right. So bright and early, it was Saturday morning, and Saturday before Easter, in fact, we loaded up the pickup truck and headed to the city. But let me tell you, we was not prepared for what we find, no sirree.
Really?
Yeah, when we got there, me and Granny, we went and looked for a telephone, and Luther and Corvette wandered off and met up with some strange city critters.
Yo, y'all. I beg your pardon? She said, yo, doll.
We didn't bring our dog with us. He said she don't take to kindly strangers.
Yeah, but we brought our goat, Henry. He's real nice and hungry all the time.
So watch what you leave laying around, because he'll eat anything.
Dude. No, the name's Cormaine, and this here's my brother Luther.
What up? I reckon, what's your name?
G. Just G, like the letter G? You can call me Cool G. Give me five.
Five what?
Your coolest in the heart. Snoop T. Give me some pounds. A pound of what? Are they keeping it real?
Man, we got so far out.
We do live along. We do live a ways out of here, all right.
Yeah, you know what they say? Pull Millie from out of the county and Millie out of the state. You got game. You all that. Are they speaking English?
I don't know. Excuse me, we do not speak your language.
Easter in the first place.
What do you mean, Uncle Yule?
Well, where we was, it sounded like folks was talking a different language. Must have been how God felt when he sent his son.
Huh?
Yeah, he'd been trying to show us how much he loved us and everything. And when God sent Jesus to the earth, well, he wasn't what folks expected. And they didn't rightly understand it.
Bye.
this little baby named Jesus, he was a precious, sweet young thing. And this baby, he can make them angels, you know what? He can make them angels way up in heaven sing. But down here, upon this old earth, so few people really believe. He's the light of the world, but they could not see. As he healed folks, and as he performed all those many miracles. But they still really didn't even know why, just why this Savior had even came. Jesus came here to build a heavenly kingdom, a heavenly kingdom.
Time. He was the first.
we went to the city for Easter.
Oh, that. It was a sight for sure. We saw things we ain't never seen before and hope to never see again.
Like what, Granny?
Like the Beatles, for one.
Now, Granny, the food wasn't so bad.
It was worse than bad. They took us to a, what kind of place was it, Yule?
Sushi bar, I think it was.
Yeah, I said it was a fish place.
What, fried catfish, Granny?
No, it wasn't fried at all. It was plum raw.
Raw?
Yeah, we didn't want to say anything, but the fish was way undercooked.
Oh, sounds horrible.
It was, but it wasn't as bad as everything else we went through. Right after we got there, Yule and me went to find a phone and we couldn't find one. And Luther and Cora May wandered off.
I done told them that, Granny.
Oh, well, did you tell them they were scared?
I was getting to that.
Did Luther and Cora May find you and Granny?
No, not right away.
Them youngins kept wandering further and further off. Got themselves lost as last year's Easter egg.
Which was another good comparison we found to the Easter story. Because God's whole reason in the first place for sending his son was to find and save the lost. Called a violation of the city code.
What city code?
We didn't know. See, we couldn't find
apparently city folks don't take too kindly to billy goats grazing in their vacant lots. The police came, they was trying to say we was criminals.
You criminals?
That's what they said.
Was that another Easter comparison?
It was.
I don't get it.
Jesus, way back there in Jerusalem, was hauled in and called a criminal, wasn't he?
He was, and it violated nary code. Never even committed one sin.
Oh yeah, so what happened to y'all next?
Well, there we was, locked up in the slammer on bread and water.
Now, Granny, we wasn't on bread and water. Well, anyhow, the police wouldn't let us leave the station, and we had no way of telling Luther Corvey where we was, and they were worried too, and that's when they met up with them two city critters again.
Yo, dog, what up?
You again?
Right now, Plowboy, y'all and I blocked down.
Wow!
Hey, fellas, we need help find someone.
Bro, don't sweat it, we're cool.
We need to find Uncle Yule and Granny.
We did.
Yeah, I've got a shovel in the truck.
Let me handle this, Cormac. Here's the address of our city cousins.
But we've got to find Uncle Yule and Granny.
I said, let me handle this.
Yo, go down 2 blocks, and a wheezy, and a reezy. And if you go too far, just make a gooey.
I don't know any of them fellas you're talking about. I just need help finding my family and my friends.
Maybe if we call our city cousins, they can help us find Uncle Yule and Granny.
Can you help us find a telephone?
Yo, you don't have a cell?
No, we don't have nothing to sell, but I got some spare change for a payphone.
Yo, we can reach out and tell somebody for you.
Is that a telephone?
It's the Mac Daddy Wireless Communication. Well, that ain't no bigger than a chicken leg.
That's the reason.
Could y'all call our city cousins for us?
For shizzle.
Here's the number.
I hope that means yes.
It means yes. I'll give you a 5.
And I'll give you a pound.
He said, Father, I'm afraid of this day.
Who are you?
Junior, Jesse, meet Cool G and Snoop T.
If he saved others, let him save himself if he can. The soldiers also mocked him, saying, "Fear the king of the Jews, save yourself."
And after a while, Jesus cried out in pain, bowed his head, and died. It was at noon, and darkness fell over the land for 3 hours.
A man named Joseph, a good and righteous man, went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus.
And Joseph took Jesus' body down from the cross and wrapped it in a linen cloth and laid him in a tomb which he had cut out in rock and rolled a large stone against the entrance of the tomb and went away. Some women followed and saw the tomb rolled to the side and seen how his body was laid.
On the day of the week, Mary Magdalene and other women went to the tomb while it was still dark and saw that the tomb of the stone was still rolled away.
Entering the tomb, they saw a young man, an angel, sitting at the right wearing a white robe, and they were amazed. And the angel said, "Do not be afraid. You are looking at Jesus who has been crucified.
He is not here. He has risen."
Yeah.